So let's begin question number 9. What is given? Current assets are given 7,50,000. Current assets are given 7,50,000. Working capital is 2,50,000. Working capital is given 2,50,000. And we need to compute current ratio. Current ratio means current assets upon current liabilities. Both are not given, है ना? But we have formula of working capital, current assets minus current liabilities. Working capital is given 2,50,000 and current asset is given 7,50,000. We can easily compute current liability, yes or no? So current liability is equal to 7,50,000 minus 2,50,000. So current liability will be 5 lakh. So now we have current liability and current asset is already given in the question. So we can compute current ratio. 7,50,000 divided by current liability 5 lakh. Isn't it or not? So we will get 1.5:1. I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Question number 10. A company had current assets of rupees 4,50,000. Fine. So current assets given 4,50,000. Points which are given we write first. And current liabilities of rupees 2 lakh. Current liabilities of rupees 2 lakh. Afterwards it purchased goods for 30,000 on credit. Goods of rupees 30,000 purchased on credit. Will it affect current asset? Children, tell me. When we purchase goods of rupees 30,000, will it affect current asset?
Yes, sir.
Yes. It will increase or decrease?
Sir, it will increase both of them, liability and asset both.
Yes, current asset will increase. Will it? Will current liabilities will be affected?
Yes, sir.
Current liabilities will also be increased because we have purchased on credit now. It means we need to pay. It is our liability. It means current asset and current liability both are increased by rupees 30,000. And according to question, calculate current ratio after the purchase. So current ratio after the purchase. We can calculate very easily. Now current asset become 4,50,000 plus 30. है ना? 4,50,000 plus 30,000. Current asset is increased by 30,000. Current liability will also be increased by 30,000 because creditors increased. 4,50,000 plus 30, 4,80,000. 2 lakh plus 30, 2,30,000. So when we compute ratio, what we get? We get 2.09:1. Is that clear, my dear children? Let's begin with question number 11. Let's see what is given. Current liabilities of a company were 1,75,000. So given current liabilities of a company were 1,75,000 and its current ratio was 2:1, and at that time current ratio was 2:1. This is given. It paid 30,000 to a creditor. Paid 30,000 to creditor. Okay. Calculate current ratio after the payment. Okay. But before calculating current ratio after the payment, first we need to calculate current assets before the payment. So current ratio is 2:1. So we can calculate current assets very easily. How to calculate? Current assets, current ratio is equal to current asset upon current liability. Current ratio is given 2:1. So we can write 2/1. Hai na? Current asset is not given, but current liability is given 1,75,000. So by cross multiplication we can calculate current assets. Yes or no? So 1,75,000 into 2, 3,50,000. So current asset before payment is 3,50,000. Current liability before payment is 1,75,000. Now come to the question. We need to compute current ratio after the payment. So let's calculate current ratio after payment. ठीक है, so let's calculate current ratio. Formula of current ratio is current assets upon current liabilities. Current assets we have computed 3,50,000. Current liabilities were given 1,75,000. Let's subtract what is paid. How much is paid? 30,000. So when we pay to creditor, what we pay? Cash. Cash is current asset. Cash is current asset, है ना? So current assets decreased by 30,000. When we pay cash, our liabilities also decreased, because creditors decreased by rupees 30,000. Yes or no? Hana? It will be affected both. When we pay cash to creditor, current assets will also decreases. Current liability will also decreases. Hana? So 3,50,000 minus 30,000. 3,20,000. 1,75,000 minus 30. 1,45,000. So calculate current ratio. So let us calculate current ratio. 320 divide 320 divide by 145. 2.20. Is 2:1. I hope it is clear to everyone. Ratio of current assets 3 lakh means current asset is given 3 lakh. Current assets given 3 lakh. Current liability is 2 lakh. And their ratio is also given. 1.5:1 current ratio. Current ratio is 1.5:1. All these things are given. Hana? Then the accountant of the firm is interested in maintaining a current ratio of 2:1. What accountant want? He want that I do not want 1.5:1. It is better 2:1. By paying off a part of current liability. compute the amount of current liability that should be paid so that current asset at the level of 2:1 to be maintained. So how much current liability is to be paid? Huh?
Sir, 50,000.
We need to solve it. Let us assume, let's take X current liability is paid. Okay. So what will be the current ratio? The formula of current ratio is current asset upon current liability. Right now, current asset is 3 lakh and right now current liability is 2 lakh. We need to pay some amount. We do not know how much. So let us take X is paid. So X is paid, so cash is decreased, current asset is decreased. X is paid the same amount means liability is decreased. And now what ratio we want? We want ratio 2:1 means 2:1. I hope this equation is clear to everyone. So let us cross multiply, hai na? So when we cross multiply, what we get? We get 3 lakh minus x, then 2x minus 4 lakh. Isn't it or not? So x will go here and 4 lakh will come here. So it will be 2x minus x is equal to 4 lakh minus 3 lakh. So x will be 1 lakh. 1 lakh. Hai na? So that much current liability is to be paid. That much current liability to be paid to maintain the ratio 2:1. I hope the question is clear to everyone. Question number 13. Ratio of current assets 8,75,000. So what is given? Current asset is given 8,75,000. Current liability is given 3,50,000. And its ratio is given 2:5:1. Current ratio is also given 2:5:1. The firm wants to maintain current ratio of 2:1. Firm wants that current ratio should be 2:1, not 2:5:1. The firm wants to maintain current ratio by purchasing goods on credit. So compute the amount of goods that should be purchased on credit. So we need to compute how much goods to purchase on credit to maintain the ratio 2:1. So let's take X goods purchased on credit. Hai na? So when we purchase goods on credit, will it affect current asset? Yes, it will increase current asset. And when we purchase goods on credit, will it affect current liability? Yes, current liability will also be increasing. Hai na? So we will make equation current ratio is equal to current asset upon current liabilities. Current asset is given 8,75,000 and current liability is given 3,50,000. So when we purchase goods on credit, obviously current asset will increase, but with how much amount we do not know. So we write X, and current liability will also be increased with the similar amount. And we want to maintain the ratio 2:1. Can we solve this? Yes, simple by cross multiplication. Hai na? 1 will be multiplied with 875 and X, and 2 will be multiplied with 350,000 and X. So let us solve. Hai na? So 1 into 875,000 plus X is equal to 350 into 2, 7 lakh plus 2X. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So 2X minus X is equal to 875,000 minus 7 lakh. So 2X minus X and 875,000 minus 7 lakh, 1,75,000. Do you understand? So what is required? This much goods.
Yes, sir.
This much goods has to be purchased on credit. Hai na? I hope this question is clear to everyone.